The Philippine Justice Department has issued a subpoena to Senator Coco Pimentel over his alleged breach of quarantine protocols. Let's get details now. Now on the line, ABS-CBN correspondent Mike Navallo. Mike, go ahead.
Hi, Ron. Prosecutor General Benedicto Malcontento has just confirmed that the Department of Justice has issued today a subpoena for Senator Aquilino Pimentel III over his alleged breach of quarantine protocols. Pimentel is facing a complaint filed by lawyer Rico Quicho, former dean of University of Makati School of Law, for allegedly violating Republic Act number 11332 when he accompanied his then pregnant wife at the Makati Medical Center on March 24, despite undergoing testing for coronavirus disease or COVID-19 on March 20. Pimentel, who admitted to experiencing COVID-19 symptoms, said he was only informed that he tested positive for COVID-19 while in Makati Med and immediately left the hospital. Both the hospital and the Department of Health confirmed there was a breach of quarantine protocol. Benedicto also disclosed the preliminary investigation is tentatively scheduled on May 20. In a Facebook post earlier today, Quicho said he received an order from the Department of Justice requiring him to appear within 5 days from the lifting of the enhanced community quarantine with hard copies of his complaint and annexes and to swear to his complaint under oath. Justice Secretary Minaldo Guevara earlier said the Justice Department will immediately schedule a preliminary investigation on the complaint against Pimentel on an appropriate date given the Luzon-wide lockdown. The DOJ probe is separate from that of the National Bureau of Investigation. Both Pimentel and Guevara received strong criticisms online, Pimentel for his actions, and Guevara for his statement that the DOJ will temper the rigor of the law with human compassion when asked for comment regarding Pimentel's case. Authorities have arrested thousands of violators of the enhanced community quarantine protocols. Some were warned, others fined, but there were also others who were prosecuted, such as protesters from Sitio San Roque in Quezon City who were arrested for holding a protest action. They have since been released on bail. Ron?
Thanks for that report, Mike Navallo.